Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video will highlight the best apps for distance learning with a focus on Google education tools. A new school year is almost upon us, and many teachers will find themselves remote teaching, and many students will find themselves remotely learning as well. So I think highlighting some of the best apps for distance learning could be really helpful. And diving into them now to give you time to really get comfortable with them before the school year is key. Before we get started, if you're a teacher, you want to keep in mind two things. First, make sure that any of the apps or websites you want to use have been approved by your school. And second is something I call technology equality. So keep your students in mind here. Do they all have access to the same remote learning options? So with those things in mind, let's jump in to some of the best apps for remote learning, Google Edition. And first up is Google Classroom. This is your hub for all things EDU. So think of Google Classroom like your central learning hub. With Google Classroom, you'll be able to create, distribute, and grade student assignments. Now, you can also add announcements and respond to your student inquiries here too. Now, plus Google Classroom completely integrates with your already existing Google ecosystem. So I want you to think your Gmail, your Google Calendar, your Drive. So that includes Docs and Sheets and Slides. It's all encompassing. Now, I won't get into all the features of how to use Google Classroom, or else we'd be here all day, but it's definitely one of the most robust services for teachers and students. And chances are your school's already using it. So now let's move on to my next pick for Google EDU app, and that's Google Jamboard. And guess what? That's all part of your Google Drive ecosystem as well. There are actually two ways to access Jamboard. Now you can head to jamboard.google.com, or you can access it directly from the apps in your Drive. Jamboard is your online whiteboard. You can change the background, so if you need graph paper, for example, you could do that. You can draw, just like you would expect from a whiteboard, basically, and adjust your writing tool as preferred. Look, oh boy, okay, this is my freehand mouse drawing attempt at the Stanley Cup, not so great. I guess I shouldn't quit my day job, but no worries, because you can actually erase anything as well. There we go. Now you can add sticky notes to important info and move those sticky notes around and resize them. Now, if you're about as a talented drawer as I am here, you can actually upload an image instead. And if you run out of space, just add another frame. And because this is all part of the Google ecosystem, you can add your Jamboard to your Google Classroom as well as extra material, for example, or you can pull it up for use in a live video chat. And speaking of video chat apps, you all know what's coming next. Drumroll, please. Google Meet. What? I told you, you know what's coming next. Now, I've done a few videos before on Google Meet, so I'll be sure to link to them at the end of this video and below this video as well. But here's why I think Google Meet is essential to remote learning. There are actually four reasons Google Meet is a winner for distance learning and teaching. Number one, security. Google Meet is a web-based application, not an app that needs to be downloaded directly to your desktop. Not having to worry about a physical app that can be hacked or compromised is a plus. Number two, accessibility. Yes, you need a Google account to start a Google Meet, but you don't need one to join a Meet. So if not all of your students have a Google account, it doesn't matter. You can send them a custom meeting link and they can join the meeting. Plus, since Meet is that web app like I talked about, it works across multiple browsers too. So think Chrome, Mozilla, Safari, and more. So it doesn't matter what your participant's preferred browser is. Number three, integration. Since Meet is already part of the Google ecosystem, it's just another added feature of Google's EDU offerings. And number four, Google Meet is free. unlike its competitors. So with all of that said, you can head to meet.google.com to start or join a meeting, or you can start one right from your Gmail, GCal, or Drive. And Meet has great features built right in, like customized screen sharing options and the ability to add captioning to your meetings. You can also customize Google Meet with some great Chrome extensions, like being able to take class attendance, for example. And I've made a video on that, which I'll be sure to link to in the description and again at the end of the video. And if you guys want to learn any more great Google features or just how to use Google Meet, you can click right up here for that video. And I'll link to it everywhere else as well. So those are my top three picks for the best apps for distance learning, Google EDU style. So now I want to hear from you guys. What do you think about Google's education options? Do you love them? What else do you want to see? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and oh look, here and here for more Google videos. Do it. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.